Well, our life together before Barry got sick was, we were just at the stage that financially things were going well for us. Our 30th anniversary, we took a cruise, our very first, to Alaska. After that, we went on a trip to San Francisco, and it was wonderful. It was wonderful being able to do things after working so hard for many years. So, and we began to have a really good time traveling, which we hadn't done for many years, actually at all. Barry first started getting what he thought was backaches. He thought he pulled something in his back when he was first, these symptoms first appeared. He went to the doctor, had many tests. Finally, the last test that he had was a chest x-ray, which was the telling evidence that something was dramatically wrong. And from there, went for further testing and biopsies, which concluded ultimately that he had mesothelioma. The doctor, after he did the biopsy on my husband, came into the room and gave us the news. He didn't present it in a very compassionate manner either, and that was very difficult, certainly for my husband, and it was for me, but he was the one that was given the news. I just had to deal with it, and then of course, telling my children was the most difficult part of all of this. And of course, each one of them was absolutely devastated. It's not news that anybody was certainly wanting to hear. Barry's treatment actually consisted of a procedure where they drained fluid from his lung. It was extremely painful. The first time I was out in the waiting room and I could hear him yelling from pain. After that, I remember one time they asked me if I would like to come in with him, and I just couldn't be there. And I was down the hall listening to him screaming, and it was very difficult, very difficult. To give a recommendation of what others would do going through this is a difficult question. Because it's a difficult time, at least I, panicked and really didn't know where to turn. Of course, medical treatment was key. That was number one. Is there a cure for this? Is there something that we could do to prolong Barry's life? I looked into a clinical trial and managed to get him into a program where he could be treated that would perhaps give him a longer time, which I'm not sure whether that did or not in retrospect. They gave my husband 8 months and he survived 11. So perhaps the treatment worked. I'd like to think it did. And then to get advice, the thing that was really important to me was to try and find somebody else that was going through this. I actually found in Colorado, where we're from, some other people that were going through the same thing, other family members, and that was huge, huge to me, to talk to others about, you know, treatments, what they were doing. That was important to me. One of the things that I did promise my husband before he died, that I would have my day in court on his behalf. And that was huge. And I'm really thankful that that transpired and that we did manage to get our day in court. I feel I kept my promise, and that was important. My experience with Levy Phillips and Konigsberg was nothing less than wonderful. I found everybody, without exception, from the person that answers the phone here to the assistants and people that I don't really know, what their position was, to be nothing but helpful, compassionate. The attorneys that I work with during the trial, I found to be professional. But more than that, their compassion was genuine. Their concern was genuine. There was nothing phony about anybody that I have worked with here at all. I would recommend this company highly. They were very honest, very caring, gave me numbers they could be reached at any time, their cell numbers, and when I did call, they were there. And I was very, very impressed with the mainly the compassion of this firm. There wasn't one person who didn't return a phone call almost immediately. And that impressed me too. That's rare in any company, but I found it to be very, they were very good at this firm. The results of the case and the trial, I was just very pleased with. I was pleased more than anything that they were found guilty, because that made me feel like I had followed through with the promise that I had made my husband. Of course, at the time, you sort of are doing that not knowing that anything will ever come to fruition, certainly at trial, which was not something that I had expected. When the jury went to deliberate, my daughter came with us. She also testified, Emily. And I remember saying to her, well, if it's quick, we know we've lost. And we went out, we actually went shopping a few blocks away, and the phone rang, and Juan called. And the first thing we looked at, and we just shook our heads, and we just assumed that we had lost the case. And we went as quickly as we could back to the court, and was absolutely stunned because of the quick verdict that we had won. To me, that was huge.